Welcome to You Have to Use Photoshop Because You Suck at Photo Impact Pro tutorial. I found a picture of your girlfriend. Well, it's one she sent me on Facebook when she was complaining about the way you treat her. So I think this photo will work just fine. We can start by pulling in her face and neck a little. Take out some of the weight she gained from birthing six of your awful children. Just simply do this with the warping tool found in the left tool panel. Now remember, this is just the beginning stages of trying to fix the damage you've done to her. Then using the warping tool, we can pull up her sagging breasts. You know, the ones she gained from having to breastfeed the entire litter of demon spawn you gave her. Using the warping tool again, we can start to shrink her belly a little for her. Using the clone tool, we can copy the line on her shirt. We can cover up the belly overhang that she carries with her as a constant reminder of why she no longer loves you. We do with this with the paintbrush cloning tool. You know, giving her the appearance of what she may have looked like if you knew how to use a condom. Go back to your warping tool here. We'll bring a little bit of her belly up and in, get rid of some of those dark spots, make it look a little smaller. Using the cloning tool again, we can separate her arm from her waistline. Simply do this by cloning some of the background sand, sort of from a parallel region. This is going to cause a blur, but we can fix this blur in a minute. That blur is sort of much like the rest of her life is going to be after raising six of your little bastards. So let's have a look at her waistline now. We can pull in her waistline, you know, give her back some of her dignity that you stole from her. Use the warping tool. And again, you know, this is going to create a little bit of a blur, but we can correct that in a minute. Just pull in the sides, and you can see the trauma you've put her through. So if we want to fix some of this blur, what we do now is we use a cloning tool, the paintbrush cloning tool, and copy some of the sand in the background and go over the blurred areas your damage has created. This pulls her waistline in and to a nice smooth line. You may find that you're covering up a lot of blurred areas, but that's all right. You know, she's birthed six children for you, and you know, I think this is the least you can do is sort of give her a decent Facebook profile picture. After all, you know, she is raising six of your demon spawn. So we do this for both sides. We do this wherever we've created a blur from the warping tool. And it's, you know, a simple copy and paste using the cloning paintbrush tool. So you can just go around and look for areas that need touched up, like the point here on her breast that I've removed, or the curve on her hips. And just clone and paint an area that may look disturbed or out of place. Have a good look, make sure you've fixed everything. And just, you know, repeat the process as many times as you feel it needs to be. Cloning and painting over wherever you feel the photo needs touch-ups. Just try not to get her pregnant again, because I can't fix all your mistakes. You know, and I personally feel that this is a better program than Photoshop. I think Photo Impact is a better program. There's no layers to deal with, and it's an image-based program. So you start with a base image, like your girlfriend here on the beach, and you can overlay images on top. Instead of having to create new layers or layer upon layer, you just have images set onto the base background, and you can move them around, and the base background stays still. And so all in all, I think it's the same editing, just better. Okay, now we're getting somewhere, but you know, her hips still look a little out of joint. So we can pull them in a little with the warping tool again, then clone over the blurred areas with more background pixels. You can try to pull her legs in from the inside, but you can see that doesn't really work. Sort of makes her look like she just got off a horse, and you know, that's no reference to the size of your manhood, trust me. She told me about your wee men. Anyways, pulling in her upper body again. We just repeat the process of warping in the shoulder line and breast line, and then, you know, reclone the background to go over the blurred areas. This makes for a more defined line in her posture. Throughout this process, I've sort of played with the cloning and warping sizes, the finer brushes, and you know, this is sort of similar to the effects you've had on your life, now warped of any hopes of having a personal life outside of raising all your children you burden her with. So, you know, again, we can copy the sandy background and erase any of the blurred effects the warping tool left, define any lines you may feel need defining in her posture. So all I'm doing here is just, you know, copying some of the sandy background and going over in between her arms or any other area that I sort of feel I can see too much of a blur or a defining line needs to be made. You can see here around her shoulder, it's a little blurry. So I'll just copy some of that background and paint over that with the paintbrush clone tool. And you know, you can now start to see the difference in the end result from the original picture we've created. We've pulled in her waistline, shrunk her shoulders, neck and face, lifted her breast line, and erased most of the evidence we've edited the photo in the first place. I imagine this is probably what she would have looked like if you could have just kept your pants on. So a few little things you need to touch up here before we're done. We've pulled in her chest, sort of matched that with the rest of her body, erased some of the blurs from the warping tool. And I think one or two of these little wrinkles out of her jeans make them look like they actually fit her. So, you know, now that you can see the difference and we've edited the majority of the photo here, there's still a little bit of work to do. Not 100% sure of how many kids you guys can raise on welfare, but I think six is the limit, isn't it? Alright, so I think we'll have a look at her jeans here. I want to remove one or two of these wrinkles here. Sort of make them look like they fit her and they're not, you know, tight and two sausage legs have been shoved into these pants. This is where we are so far. It's looking pretty good. It's looking like she hasn't popped out six of your children and her jeans actually fit her. She looks a little bit happier. Maybe we'll pull in her arm and shoulder a little bit so she doesn't look so much like a Sasquatch. Alright, yeah. So I don't know, what do you think of that? It's looking pretty good. There's some dark spots on her belly and chest line we should probably deal with in a minute. But we're almost done. This has taken me, maybe 15 minutes or so to get this done. She has a half-decent Facebook picture now, and she can probably delete you off her friends list and add me. So what I'm doing here is I'm sort of copying the lighter colors out of her shirt using the clone paintbrush tool and coloring over some of the darker areas in her belly so it doesn't look so dark and heavy. There's a little wrinkle here I'm going to get rid of, and you just simply clone the new area on the belly that you've painted over and use your clone paintbrush tool and clone over that wrinkle and expand the waistline, whatever that is at the bottom of her shirt there, that little pink line, and clone that over so it goes right around her waist and doesn't look like she's tucked in her shirt. You know, to try to hide the fat that you've given her. Also clone some of the lighter areas in her shirt and lightened up her breast line. It was a little dark underneath. And this is our end result, before and after.